Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.
Ladies and gentlemen, and I started off the week, I didn't actually have a clue until I had a couple of people calling me up. First of all, you have to understand that if over 10 people call you about the same thing, then it means it's something trending. It's something that they are all up about. But if only 3 people call you, then you know, well, whoever they're calling you for and are about, are really, they're not that much. Anyway, I got like about 3 phone calls. And what on the street is, I am sleeping with Joseph Mayanja. I have arrived, ladies and gentlemen. Let me tell you, in this country, if you want to know you are arriving or you are headed to a particular destination, let them just start randomly selecting who you're sleeping with. So I've slept, who did I first sleep with? Have I slept with my producer? Willis, do you? They first made me sleep with my producer to get the job. Now they're making me sleep with who? Chameleon, who? But I can't take a corner of Evangel. What do you want to know about Dubai? Dubai, Simanya is called who? But is that alright? Is that alright? Y'all is keeping me relevant and I love it. I do. Anyway, enough of that. This show is proudly sponsored by none other than Nana Habo Mouthwash. Get the product, try the product. If you haven't, this is a perfect time to try it. And if you want to reach out to them, the number is just down here. Let's delve into the things that I understand more than anything else. Gossip. So I read this blog that was talking about, I hear Eddie Cheyune and Winnie Noaja banging. Has anyone of you heard that? How, why is it possible? What? Like you people think Winnie Noaja tainabia kola nobula mugwe because Eddie Cheyune has money. Wait, does Eddie Cheyune? Oh, katwali ogere ngabwali ogere. Eddie Chun. Does he speak English? Like perfect English. But you see, I'm trying to understand. I could understand Eddie Chun with this loose girl. What's her name? Anita Fabiola. I would understand because, I mean, it's to the highest bidder. Has it also become like that for Winnie Noaja, to the highest bidder? Because they saw them coveting each other. They were this bar in town and they were all... He bought expensive drinks and then they left one scenario, went to another bar, partied, and they headed off to a very undisclosed venue. Not that we can know where they ended up. But I honestly think that these young money bags, I use the word money bags very loosely. You need to understand, I use that term loosely. But it's possible that Winnie Noaja could just be friends. Tababa mkalo kekamu. Maya bagaga bekampala basinga baveyo mbiyalo yo masaka. Bali yobwe obwalo yalo yo. Jetwa jabadoni white, bagundi Brian white jebava. Like, it's possible they could actually have just an understanding that they are badass, is it? I'm happy for her though. This is not me even throwing shade. She deserves someone to treat her, you know, like everything that she wants to be treated like. Because the last guy was a rustabout, had no really decent job. He had a failed music career and she claims she was picking up all the slack and the bags and the money. So it's good that she gets someone who wants to lavishly spend on her or, you know, just plain someone who wants to tap that ass. Because honey, you got that any man would want to tap. You have put that ish out on display. Not that it's your fault. We need to thank your mother for giving you what she gave you. But in the process, I need you to understand you're going to be sleeping with loads of Cheyunes in this world. I just hope you're the permanent one. Tana. Guess what? B2C was that their first concert? It was their maiden concert. Oh my goodness. I did not talk about it before when they were, you know, advertising and it was going on because I somewhat felt like it's a bad time of the year with all the political unrest going on and with all these things going on. I thought that the people would not want to show up. And let's not forget, Nyege Nyege was around the corner. But I was shooketh, very shooketh. When Bajuza, as in Bachigala, all through and through, they filled up the concert. They had perfect, not really perfect, but they had good performances. In my head though, I was asking, wait, how many songs do they got? Is it an album? Like, we love them that much, do we? What was the edge ratio that came to attend his concert, the concert, huh? Go glutamize. I mean, anything with glutamize, we're definitely going to show up. Much love for the late radio. I mean, I'll just show up for that concert because of that one song and because it brings me closer to feeling like radio is still alive. But wow, I was blown away. Big up to Andy Evans, man. They made it happen. It's a... Someone had told me what I was saying, but then why should we care if Tip Swizzy's pants ripped? Anyone's pants can rip. Have you met Tip Swizzy? Have you met the pants Tip Swizzy wears? They are made to rip. Like, they do not ever fit him. So, I mean, ripping, that's... It's like that's what they're supposed to do. Rip. Have you met those pants? It's like someone telling Eddie Kenzo, okutambule chigere, na kuba woluta, oluwanvu in the pants he wears. I know who you lika. As in, it's Tip Swizzy. Wait, was he wearing underwear though? And on a much, much sober and much confused note, we all saw what happened over the weekend. We lost Chirumira. It was a very scary thing, man. I was at home and social was just buzzing. And I'm like, what's happening? And certain times I don't have anything to say, really. Like, I have so much to say that I actually don't have nothing to say. But this is all I can say. I mean, major condolences go out to his bereaved, of course, that's his wife, and his beautiful kids, man. Those were very young kids to leave behind. And he was so young to die in such a senseless way. I do not know, man. It's a very, very sad thing, you know? We send out our heartfelt condolences to the family and, of course, you know, to all the bereaved and to the nation as a fact, because he was a police officer, you know, they're here to protect and serve, and that makes them ours, you know. So whenever they feel a loss, we feel a loss too. It was a very sad thing, very sad. On a lighter note, so yesterday the president addressed the nation for how many hours? 4! I signed out on the 20th minute. I'm like, yo, because I knew Sosho was going to give it to me. Sosho definitely gives it to you. And then the first clip that social media get to me is the one that is so disturbing with our president coughing in. Ay, Jesus. Anyway. So today this is even, this was just mind blowing. I watched Vinka's new video, Omukwanogo, I think. The only thing that was going through my mind is Jeff Chiwa must be under a rock somewhere, cursing the day Swans Avenue gave Vinka a chance to be a star. Jesus is the Lord. This girl is churning out songs every 5 seconds. Every 5 seconds, there's a new Vinka song, and it comes complete with the video. Like, they've stolen his entire concept, because that was a Jeff Chiwa thing. He would drop an audio today and a video tomorrow. That's just how we did. But Vinka, banana Vinka, inokubanga, suza shiba bubi, shiba mchamula bali. Well, did she go for you now? Yeah, I think she did. But have you all noticed how silent Sheba has gone? There is nothing from her. Titeri kapia, enyimba nebwa yimba damu tetu chaya garamanya, tuliku chips in a ketchup. Man, that's a beautiful thing. I'm proud of Vinka. I am really proud of her, and I hope she keeps the tenacity going, because only Sheba has managed to be that tenacious all this time and still kept on winning. But Vinka, ooh, sure fire, that girl was hungry for fame. I think yali akoye okustula chai wa Irene, okumuambaza, okumudukidida, because she was just tired, and it's her time to shine. It's a beautiful thing. I'm not so sure about the new song. It is Vinka, and it is Ugandan music. What do we expect? But I'm happy for her. I am more than happy. My producer is extremely happy because he has had a crush on her for how long? Wait, it's not a crush, you bang. And in other news, 27 Guns, the official, I'd like to believe it's like they got the mustard seed and then they turned it into a script, but hey, to each his own. It was released, the president did come too, the first daughter was there, beaming happiness. I have a couple of friends who were rubbing shoulders with the big man. I was like, damn, I should have come for these auditions. But I haven't yet watched the movie, but they're saying it is epic, it is legendary, and I cannot wait. But the thing though, it's going to be quite hard for me to watch the movie now, given what's happening, and take it all in. Or maybe it could be the other way, you know? I could see what's happening and watch the movie and appreciate what's happening or what happened. I don't know, man. It's mixed emotions. But yo, it went down. The whole place was it. But now, when the president is coming to a place, what if I want to well, I really? They closed off the entire Nali. I was like, what the hell? So I can't go shopping because of a movie premiere? Come on. Like, the president, I felt like the president shouldn't have come. Like, oh wait, the first lady has a bigger security detail than the president, so still they were going to, you know. But hey, I can't wait to watch the movie. I'm not watching it because I believe it's a dope movie. I'm watching it because I have so many upcoming movie artists in there who are my friends. So I'm supporting the culture. And I'm also supporting the fact that I love movies. So, yeah. Oh, well, that's what happened over the weekend. What else was I going to talk about? Oh, yeah. I saw Zari posted something on her Insta. And it was, like, beautiful advice. I was shocked. I was like, damn, this girl pretty much knows how to caption everything. But it seems like the advice and the message was directed towards Hamisa. And the part where she goes like, I love you sis from TZ, but you know what? Get it together. I was like, best damn thing that any co-wife can tell another. Best damn thing. But the thing though, right now, we have bigger fish to fry. But we're Maridi, Akasanja Kamuke, Kabaku game. People make diamond platinum. This star is falling, like falling. By end of next year, we're not going to know him. Nayaka Sanjaka Muneka Imidiza Uganda ne Tanzania Karinachi. I wanna know what does diamond platinums have in his pants that gets all the girls gaga, because I know it for a fact. It is not what's in his pants, it's pretty much what's in the bank. At Tina Fierce One is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop and at Tina Fierce One. Don't forget, like and follow the pages on Instagram. Yes, I'm at Tina Fierce One with an H on it. Catch you again tomorrow when we delve into what's happening in the world of celebrity. This particular episode, Nana Habo Mouthwash. I don't need to sing it, but I will sing it because, well, I'm paid tons of money and I believe in the product. Buy the product, try the product. That's the only thing you can do for it. I'm out. Peace.
Scoop and Scoop was sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.